Want to see the most badass Michael Bay-like beer opening ever?
So hopefully you enjoyed that sequence I just showed you at the very beginning. I know there were a lot of different clips, but you know, in the last 2 weeks I shot so much stuff that I mean, it had no story, so I just had to somehow mash all the clips together, but hopefully you got the idea what this lens is actually capable of. Yeah, that looked sick. Some shots, like, I just would never say that they were shot on a Sony Alpha 6500. Like, really, it looked so cinematic. It looked like it was shot, like, on a Blackmagic Pocket 6K or something. Let's talk about the lens a little bit. The first thing I noticed when I picked this lens up is how well it's built. Like, it's so solid. I don't know what kind of metal is it, but it's metal. It's not plastic. And it weighs a lot. It's basically like the camera, the Sony Alpha 6500 itself, which is freaking crazy. So yeah, the build quality just feels so good. Once you pick it up in your hands, it doesn't feel like a toy. It feels like a proper tool. Next thing, let's talk about the price. Now, it starts from $649. That's all you need to know, pretty much. Let me explain it in a different kind of a way. Prior to SIRUI, the cheapest anamorphic lens you could get was for like $2,000 or $3,000. And if you want a really solid one, it can cost up to $50,000. And now, for just $649, you can not rent this lens, but you can actually own this lens. So Yeah, to kind of think about it, SIRUI really shook the market quite a bit. Okay, we gotta talk about the focusing ring and the aperture ring, because those two features are freaking crazy. When I picked up the lens, I saw that it had an aperture ring, right? I was like, oh, sweet, okay. Like every single lens I've used pretty much has like a clicky kind of an aperture ring, right? So I was like, okay, it's clicky. And then when I turned it, I was like, no way. It's actually a non-clicky aperture ring, which means that you can control your exposure without having those nasty clicks, and that's amazing. At first, I kind of thought I'm not gonna be using that feature too much, but I'm using it all the time. I'm not even adjusting the shutter speed anymore, I'm only adjusting the aperture, and it feels so good. It's like, it's kind of stiff, so this means if you're gonna be holding the camera like this and your fingers are gonna be touching the aperture ring, you're not gonna accidentally change the exposure, because you need to put a little bit of a force into it in order to change it, and that, my friend, is brilliant. They really thought this through. The focusing ring, it ain't the focus by wire focusing system, so I can definitely tell you that it's worth a shot. It's really good. It feels so smooth. And to get from one end to the other one, like the minimal focusing distance to infinity focus, you freaking need to do like a 360 spin almost, and that is great. Because, you know, focus by wire systems are like, it's a hit or miss kind of a situation. With this lens, it's good shit. It's good shit. Let's talk about the most important thing, and that is the image quality. I mean, you saw the beginning. I can't really explain it, but this lens has a soul. When you look at this kind of footage, it doesn't look like Sony footage at all. 0%. I would never be able to tell that it's Sony footage. The out of focus elements feel so different. The vibe feels so different. The contrast, the sharpness, it's just, there's something about this lens which just feels good. When you look at this footage, you just feel happy. I can't really explain it. You gotta test it out for yourself. You know, this is that type of lens which I would totally recommend you to just rent out for a day and shoot with it, because the image you're gonna get out of this is just incredible. When it comes to aperture, yes, on 1.8, it's a little bit soft, however, still completely usable. In slow motion, on the Sony Alpha 6500, on 1.8, it's... I don't know how I feel about it, really. It's okay if you're pretty close and the background's out of focus, but for infinity focus on 1080p slow-mo, nah, not really, not feeling it. 4K, however, super sharp. Now, when you go 2.8 to 5.6 aperture, it's super sharp. It's one of the sharpest lenses I've tested out. I would say it's almost the same sharpness as the Samyang 12mm lens, and that is a hell of a sharp lens, okay? What I like about the lens as well, like on the sides, it has this kind of a ellipse blur effect or something. It just feels different. It looks cool, right? Now, here's the thing I'm a little bit disappointed about. The bokeh is not as pronounced as I would like it to be. Even when you get kind of close to it, close to your subject, you can see the oval bokeh. Don't get me wrong, you can still see it. But I kind of wanted to see it a little bit more pronounced. I guess if you want to see that oval bokeh effect, like really see an over-exaggerated version of it, you must get the SIRUI 50mm, but for the 35mm, you can still get the effect, and it's still nice. But overall, I'm just loving this lens. I can definitely tell you guys that you're gonna be seeing more videos shot on this lens, and we're actually planning on shooting a short film with just this lens, probably, and that's gonna be sick. Since this is kind of a new tool, and I've never used anything like this before in my life, I've used this for like around 3 weeks now, but I have a feeling that I need to use it for like half a year in order to be able to tell you a lot of things I don't like about it, but that's pretty much it. I know some of you probably expected a more kind of a detailed review, right, with all the specs and all those crazy numbers, but I ain't all about that. I just showed you like a 2-minute cinematic B-roll sequence at the very beginning just to show you guys what you can manage with this lens and the Sony Alpha systems. This video was almost entirely shot on the anamorphic lens. There were just a couple of B-roll shots where you could see me working with the lens, which were not shot with on an anamorphic lens, but other than that, everything was shot on this anamorphic SIRUI 35mm lens. And the second thing, I want to talk about the workflow a little bit, because when I got this lens, I had no idea how to work with anamorphic footage. It's so simple, really. I was not expecting it to be simple. For some reason, I thought Premiere can't even edit anamorphic footage. I don't know why. I thought I would have to download DaVinci Resolve or something, but literally all you need to do is open Premiere, drag the footage in, right click, interpret, and then there's a I don't know how that setting is called, but here on the screen you can see, it's like you just change the aspect ratio to 1.33 times anamorphic D squeeze or something, and that's it, you're done, you're good to go. The only thing I kind of didn't understand, maybe I still haven't found a way, but if you guys could help me out with this, that would be very cool. I was trying to warp stabilize the clips, the de-squeezed clips, and even when I was nesting them and stuff like that, I couldn't warp stabilize them. My warp stabilizer wasn't just not working. Is it my Premiere, or do you guys have the same kind of a problem? If you could let me know that in the comment section below, that would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, peace out!